Hey guys, Dr. Whitney Bowe here, and in this video, we're gonna be talking about UVA rays, UVB rays, and do you really need to get vitamin D from the sun? And I actually created a series of sunscreen videos for you guys, and this is the first of several. So be sure to subscribe because sunscreen is really controversial, and I'm gonna be answering all of your questions. So first, UV rays, UV light, is actually a known human carcinogen, meaning that we know that it creates DNA damage and it leads to skin cancer. UV light also is the primary cause of pretty much all the signs of aging that you see on your skin. And the number one cause of those signs is actually ultraviolet exposure. So we're talking about fine lines, wrinkles, uneven pigmentation, brown spots, uneven tone, loss of elasticity, all those great things that you really don't want to happen in your skin. Now, I am the first to admit that being outside has a tremendous benefit, right, for our overall health, specifically when it comes to our emotional and psychological well-being. It's really important to understand how the UVA and UVB rays work so that you can be empowered to make good decisions about just how much time you're spending outside and what to do to protect your skin. So UVB rays range from 280 to 315 nanometers. They're actually short wavelengths. They don't penetrate very deeply into the skin, but they do some major damage. So think B for burn, because UVB rays are the ones that are primarily responsible for a sunburn. Now UVB rays are also the ones that help your skin synthesize vitamin D. More on that later. UVA rays range from 315 nanometers to 400 nanometers. So they're a little bit longer, their wavelength. Do that with me. Anyway, it goes deeper. Those longer wavelengths, they penetrate deeper into the skin. So think A for aging. Those are the ones that actually break down your collagen and contribute to fine lines and wrinkles. Now, it's important to note that UVA rays can actually penetrate through window glass and through clouds. So right now I'm in my office, I'm at home. I've got windows behind me. There's no UVB coming in my house. But there is UVA, so I am being exposed to UVA rays right now. And on a dark, gloomy, cloudy day, you're actually still being exposed to UVA rays all year round, guys, no matter where you live. Now, both UVA and UVB lead to skin cancer, and both UVA and UVB rays actually dampen or diminish your skin's immune response. Now, that can actually be a good thing, and it can also be a bad thing. If your skin's immune system is weak, it sets you up for infection, but it also increases your risk of developing cancer. So our immune cells are actually very, very important when it comes to finding early cancer cells and stopping them from multiplying. Now, why would having a dampened or weakened skin immune system be a good thing? Well, if you have acne or you have psoriasis, I'm sure you've experienced that going out in the sun or going on a vacation on the beach, spending time in the sun can actually make that condition a lot better. And that's because sometimes our skin's immune system is overreacting. It's overzealous. So when you sort of dampen or weaken the immune response in those cases, it can actually make the skin healthier. Now, unfortunately, while your skin condition might improve with the sun, that same sun exposure is also at the same time increasing your risk for skin cancer and accelerated aging. So it's all about balance, guys. And that brings us to vitamin D, because I'm sure you guys are aware that vitamin D, it's not just good for your bones, it's actually really great for your immune system. There's been a lot of conversation about vitamin D, especially during the pandemic. So I hear a question a lot in my office and from you guys on social media, on Instagram, on TikTok. Don't I need to go out in the sun in order to get my vitamin D? And isn't the kind of vitamin D that I make from the sun the healthiest kind of vitamin D? So unfortunately, there's actually no safe way to get vitamin D from the sun. So the rays that actually are required for your skin to synthesize vitamin D are UVB rays. And UVB rays are the ones that cause DNA damage, and they absolutely increase your risk for skin cancer. And according to the most recent studies, sunscreen use does not actually cause or lead to vitamin D deficiency. You might think it would, like, oh, if you're covering up with sunscreen, you know, aren't those people going to be more likely to suffer from low levels of vitamin D? That's not what the studies are showing. And I'll actually put a link to one of those studies below so you guys can check it out. And now I'm going to share some research with you that is going to make you rethink this whole getting your vitamin D from the sun even further. And that's that UVA rays in the sun actually break down vitamin D in the skin. Let me explain that. Let's take a step back. Okay, so we just talked about how UVB actually encourages your skin to synthesize vitamin D, right? UVB, not so great. You're getting some bad side effects from it, but the good thing, you know, you're outside, at least you're getting the UVB creating some vitamin D in your skin. So studies show that actually, vitamin D in the skin is really sensitive to UVA, meaning that UVA from the sun, when you're standing out there after you've just created some vitamin D, breaks it down. The UVA breaks down the vitamin D in your skin. So in the winter months or on a cloudy day, when there's more UVA reaching your skin surface than UVB, it's actually theoretically possible that you are breaking down more vitamin D than what your skin is actually making from that sun exposure. So just all the more reason not to get your vitamin D from the sun. So in my opinion, if you're worried about your vitamin D levels, which quite honestly you should be, because vitamin D is one of the most important vitamins, not only for overall health, but for a healthy and balanced immune system, then you want to be getting it from your diet, not from the sun. You want to be getting it from supplements. So talk to your doctor about what dose makes the most sense for you. And the next time that one of your friends, you know, gives you the excuse like, oh yeah, I gotta go out in the sun, get my vitamin D, share this video with them. Now, if you're asking questions like, should I be using mineral sunscreen, chemical sunscreen? What's the deal when it comes to safety? How do I layer my sunscreen? Is a moisturizer with sunscreen enough? I will be answering all of those questions in upcoming videos. So be sure to subscribe and stay tuned for those. But in the meanwhile, check out this playlist all about how diet actually affects our skin health. All right, guys, take care. See you soon.